Hi, today I'm going to be working on the case design for a smaller version of the model railroad throttle that I've been working on. So we'll be using Fusion 360 and a little bit of Eagle, which is for the circuit board design. Welcome to another episode. In the last two episodes, I showed you a little bit about this throttle that I've been working on with a team of other people. And what I'm going to be doing in this episode is talking about another version of this throttle, which is smaller and has a different case design. I've been working with Stuart. He's working on the circuit board, and he just sent me the final version for revision A. Now, there will most likely be other revisions, but this is the one that will be the first prototype for the smaller throttle. Now, what I need to do is take his circuit design and then import all the dimensions into the design that I have for the case and make sure everything fits. So let's head over to the computer and we'll open everything in Fusion 360, and I'm going to have to position things around and see if everything fits, and then let Stuart know whether or not everything is okay so that we can have the circuit board sent out and made in time for us getting together during the first week of February, because the goal is to be able to build a prototype of this throttle, including some 3D printed cases at that get-together. Here's the design of the basic throttle, and I've started to make some changes to it. So you can see that the screen isn't in the exact right location. Basically, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to update the design based on the actual circuit board that I got from Stuart. If we hide the top, you can see I have a mock-up of the circuit board. This is something I created before the design from Stuart. So what I want to do now is take Stuart's design and pull this into how this actually fits with the actual design. So for that, I'm going to start with the design in Eagle, which you can see is right here. And if I want to export this as a DXF file. But if I export this right now, it's going to have way too many details. It's going to be a very large file and contain a lot of things that I don't really need. So I'm going to start by getting rid of some things I don't need. So I don't need the traces, the tops, etc. And if you can see, I'm already starting to eliminate a lot of things. You can see that I have the design cleaned up, a lot of the details missing. Now what I want to do is export this as a DXF file. So I'll go ahead and say export. And I want to export this in inches. I don't want the fill areas or the wire widths. But unchecking both of these will make it a lot smaller. And I don't need vector fonts either, so I'll go ahead and export that. I'm going to create a new part and import the DFX in order to create that new part. So I create a new part. The usual thing is to create a component. I'll call this component mini PCB. And the other thing I want to do is make sure that I change this from millimeters to inches, because I changed the export format to inches. So now I can go ahead and import the DXF. And then wait for it to load. Doesn't take too long. Now this has some elements that I don't need, so I'm going to go ahead and delete those. Okay, that's pretty much what I want. So the next thing I can do is I can extrude this. And I'm going to select this and initially make it 0.06 inches, which is about how thick the circuit board is. And then I have to go ahead and add in things that I really do want extruded that are not extruded by default because of all of the details in the model. Okay, and that looks good. I have a few things there that I didn't want, so I'll go ahead and fix that. Okay. And then just for fun, I like to make this so that it's green, so I'll set the appearance, and then I use matte green. And that kind of looks like a circuit board. So I'll go ahead and save this. And then once we've done that, I can go back to here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to back up to about the point where I inserted the circuit board. So that's right here. And I'm also going to turn on another feature here. So I initially started with a reference geometry. And the reason I have reference geometry is if we take a look at the side, you can see that this right here is not perfectly straight up and down. It has a draft of about 3 degrees, which is required for injection molding to help get it out of the mold. It's really for this part, so this doesn't stick to the mold. So I'm using this as the reference for all measurements. And so I'm going to actually hide the bottom. And then it's this one here. I actually have another version from earlier today. Stuart just sent me another version. Okay, so I'm going to get it somewhat close. I'm going to rotate it by 90 degrees. And then I'm going to move it a little bit, but I don't really care too much about where this is because the next step is I'm going to create a joint. So I'll just say J for joint. And then I want the circle like this, but down here. So I'll go here and then hold down the control key. And now I can select that right there. And then I want this to be aligned with right there. Plus I want an offset of 0.1 inches. And so that's the location where I want the circuit board. So if I turn the bottom back on again, you can see this is about the right location. Now, one thing you can tell from the circuit board is we need some relief here on the edges. This needs to either be chamfered or it needs a radius so that it'll fit in the part. And Stuart knows that, but he wanted to do that at the very end. Okay, so now I can go ahead and go back forward and see how things align. And one of the things that should be noticeable is, I have the other circuit board turned on, so I need to turn that one off, which is the one that I had as a temporary circuit board. So you'll see that, you know, various things are not aligned correctly. And what I need to do is go back here and change the alignment of the knob, these knobs on the side, and the display so that they're based on the new circuit board rather than the old circuit board. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then we'll come back. I'm pretty sure I have everything in the final position now, but you can see I still have a little bit more work to do. I thought I had these openings parametric based on the position of these thumb switches, but obviously that's not the case. So I'm going to have to go back and modify those. But the screen is in the right location, and the knob is in the right location, and everything else looks okay. So that means I can let Stuart know the circuit board is fine. And I have additional work that I need to do on the case. And you can tell that because if I hide the keypad, for example, which is, let's see, where's the keypad? Right here. You can see there are no holes for the keypad. So obviously that's not going to work, which means I have to add the holes for the keypad, the potentiometer, the screen, etc. So there's still more work I have to do. I also have to add a place for a lanyard. Please let me know what you think about this type of video. Let me know if there are more things you want to see, if there are some details I glossed over that you'd like to learn, that sort of thing. I'd like to make these videos something that's really of interest to the audience, and without your comments, which I will do my best to respond to, it's hard for me to know what you like and what you don't like. Again, thanks for watching. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.